What's up, everyone? This is Rita, aka Fàn Lǎoshī, your accent coach and Chinese teacher. I was so happy that many of you really enjoyed the video where I talk about why learning Chinese songs doesn't help you so much with your speaking, and instead, Chinese rap might be a lot more helpful. For those of you who still wonder why, go check out this video first. But like I promised, today I'm gonna show you a couple Chinese female rapper songs. Actually, there's a whole show filled with great music, so that you can have some more quality material to practice with, not only for the consonants and vowels, but also tones, contractions, rhythm, and beyond. But before we kick off, subscribe to this channel and hit the little bell so you don't miss out any Mandarin learning tips that you won't find anywhere else. 3, 2, 1, 订阅了吗? Let's get started. If you know anything about the Chinese rap scene, you might have heard of a show called The Rap of China, which basically brought Chinese rap music into the mainstream pop culture from the underground like overnight. And I wrote quite a lot about it when I was a Chinese rap music columnist. There are so many more Chinese rap and talent shows now, which is a good thing for Chinese learners, because you just have more fun learning materials to listen to and to practice with. Now let's watch the first episode of this all-female rap contest show, Girls Like Us, Hip-Hop 女孩, and dive into a couple songs together. Personally, I think this show is a lot better than others we've seen this summer, partly because the coaches on Girls Like Us, Ma Siwei, Vanita, Jackson Wang, and Zeng Yike are some better musicians in the scene, and they did give the contestants some good instruction throughout the show. So we saw lots of performances and songs with great music taste, cool ideas, and diverse styles. But just like the coaches focus on different subgenres of the music, the contestants have very different rapping styles in terms of rhythm, rhyming, cadence, flow, and even enunciation. And all this determine whether a rap song is good for Chinese learners to use as practice materials. Look, you can always sing any song you like for fun, but for improving your Chinese pronunciation, we should be a bit more selective. The first song I want to share with you is by Jinx Zhou. She's from Changsha, Hunan province, studied in the US, and she's super popular on Douyin and other Chinese social media now. Her music is usually more melodic, and she sings or raps a lot in English. But in the first round in this show, she rapped a lot more in Chinese. This song is called 听说你也想牵我, I heard you wanna sign me too. Let's watch a bit. There was a little mess up there, but she handled it pretty well. Did you find it hard to follow? That's totally normal. Let's use the method I introduced in my last rap video. First, slow down the playback speed. 2. Hear the pronunciation and tones more clearly. 3. Follow the beats and rap along. Let's try 0.75x speed. 他说你也不小了,再不火你就老了,别错过时机,别等着市场饱和,每次走红从来都不是机缘巧合,是一层套一层,人情世故的考核。 So you can hear that she enunciates every syllable more when rapping than in her normal speech. And to practice your spoken language, the first step is to try to pronounce each syllable clearly. And the rhyme of this verse, the Chinese vowel e, could be a hard one for a lot of Chinese learners. 老了,饱和,机缘巧合,考核. And the words and the sentence structures that she used in her verse are also more like what we tend to use in real life, like 再不火你就老了. My mom might tell me 你再不生孩子就晚了. 错过 could be useful. Someone missed the bus, train, or plane. 他起床起晚了，错过了火车，路上太堵，他错过了他的航班。 范老师要出发音课了，大家不要错过说好中文的机会。Also, there's a little grammar point. Something never happens or someone never does something, etc. Subject, 从来都不 do something. 我从来都不靠任何人。我妈妈从来都不做饭。范老师从来都不说废话。 And of course, we Chinese people love using four-character idioms, 成语, to express some more complicated concept in communication, like 机缘巧合 and 人情世故. Another reason why I love rap is that rappers tell stories with their lyrics, you know? Like, you can see the imagery, hear the conversation, and relate to people. And stories are always great sources for language learning. And you know what's crucial for language learning? Repetition! Guess what? Rappers repeat some lines quite often. And if you feel like it's kind of overwhelming to follow the whole verse, at least you will get to pick up a few lines to rap along to after listening to it a few times, like this part.感谢互联网让这游戏规则不再密不透风。感谢互联网让我在常识里面找到了漏洞。感谢互联网让我在常识里面找到了漏洞。感谢互联网让这游戏规则不再密不透风。当我触及到遥远而又真实的受众，所有的真相都不再受控。Damn, I love this girl! I actually met her in person at a music company's party, and I talked to her for like an hour. She's so cool, very expressive, like you can see from her lyrics, and she has a really strong personality. This is the superstar that Chinese pop culture really needs. 火起来! Back to this verse. You already heard 感谢互联网让这游戏规则不再密不透风 couple of times with the original tones of each syllable. Basically, you can learn the words and even the whole sentence like how you learn a song. Try it and let me know how it works in the comments. Let's check out another song. 瑞雪 was born in Xinjiang and grew up in Chongqing. Besides being a rapper, she also acts in musicals. I knew of her when she won the championship of an underground rap contest in 2019. And I'm really happy that now more people know of her and her talent through this show. In the first round, she performed a song named 错了吗? Is it wrong? The first few bars might be a bit too fast and the flow changes quickly, but we can start with the repeating part with 活该, the word you use when something bad happens to someone, and you think, they deserve it. 活该穿这么少被盯上不奇怪，活该半夜打车说明品德本就坏，活该家丑不可外扬。你看他下场不够自尊自爱，别怪人有话讲。我学会出门不穿短裤短裙，避免落单随时注意别人反应，快递单写成男性，把门口才算安心。对抗黑暗的唯一途径，竟然只有保护自己。 Again, I like the diverse topics in rap songs, and sometimes they are the ones that really need to be discussed more in public. And the ideas are delivered with detailed description, powerful words, and naturally with a cultural background. In this one verse, you can learn words that we use like every day, like 奇怪, 半夜, 打车, 怪 someone, 快递, etc. And idioms and very authentic words that might be very different phrases in other languages, like 活该 and 家丑不可外扬. Adverbs like not adjective enough, 不够, blah blah blah, and do something anytime, 随时. 如果我在视频里讲得不够清楚, 欢迎你随时在评论里留言. If you listen to it really carefully, you can also learn the tone change of 不 in a more natural way. 不穿, 不奇怪, 不可外扬. 不够. I mean, those are things you never get if you just sing a normal Chinese song. You'll be singing different notes instead of speaking with tones. Speaking of this, when it comes to the hook of a song, it usually turns to melody in most rap songs, so it won't be as helpful for your tones and speaking rhythm as the rap verses. But in this song of hers, It's great that Rui Xue keeps rapping into the hook and repeats the powerful question, 错了吗? Again and again. 错了吗?我真的错了吗?穿自己喜欢的衣服,我真的错了吗?真的错了吗?这世界到底怎么了?被害的烦恼错了吗?你不敢正面回答吧?错了吗?我真的错了吗?做自己喜欢的事情,我真的错了吗?真的错了吗?这世界到底怎么了?被害的烦恼错了吗?你不敢正面回答吧?错了吗?我真的错了吗?穿自己喜欢的衣服,我真的错了吗?真的错了吗?这世界到底怎么了?被害的烦恼错了吗?就不敢正面回答吧?Did all the 错了吗 sound the same to you? Actually, as she added up the emotion, she raised her tones, and the original fourth tone of 错 changes to a second tone-like pitch with a rising contour. It's a nuanced change, but it also shows that even in Chinese rap songs, intonation or melody might trump tones, let alone in normal pop songs. So be smart when choosing your practice materials. And if you are willing to listen to Chinese rap, that might make for great practice.Anyway, if you enjoyed the video, hit like and subscribe for more Chinese learning content. Let me know what you want to know about Chinese pronunciation in the comments. Remember, with Fàn Lǎoshī, Chinese makes perfect sense. See you in the next video.